wrapped around your ankles, you're an entrepreneur. Okay. It's in one of my books. Let's go to open forum here. Who, anybody have a success last week? Come on. Who had a success? Let's go to Nitzan and then Chris. Who else? Raise your hand if you had, and then Eric. Oh, go for it, guys.
So I had I got on a call. I was on someone's webinar and we were talking, and then I got on a call with these three gentlemen that were partnering together, and today we have their first onboarding call. So they signed up for the coaching. So that was great.
Wow. What did you do differently than maybe you didn't do before? Did you do a little analysis and say, shoot, this what I did here, this works. This is what I should be doing.
So it was usually when I get on a call with people, you know, I'll be the guy talking. And I always tell my clients, if you're talking too much when you're networking, man, you got a big L on your forehead, right? You got to keep quiet. What was nice was that I was on a Zoom call like this and I was talking about what I do and so forth. And then they came and then I got on a call with them, and they were very excited, and I picked up on it very quickly. So I didn't have to go through the whole sales process. I said, okay, you guys ready to get going right now? And they said, yes. And I just went, you know, for a lack of a better term, I went right for the jugular.
Did you tell a story? Was that emotion? Did you see yourself as an emotional salesman rather than the intellectual features and benefits and history of the world and land?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Or 13?
Yes. Yes, absolutely.
Emotional selling works, guys. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry if my regulars here, you know, I say it all the time, but I practice what I preach. Emotional selling works. Get them on the couch, on the psychiatrist's couch, okay? Get them, what are you looking for? What's the dream? What would you like to see happen? What do you think is your biggest challenge? Tell me a little bit about where, you know, what's the goal? What would you do with, get them talking, get that imagery in there. Tell stories sometimes. Ask questions with stroking and nurturing. These are all parts of a sales system designed to get to yes, get commitment, get qualification very quickly. It's why we have that little 3-minute timer. Sometimes when I'm talking to people, by the way, I turn this over, okay? Just as a reminder to me, this is the sand of my life, okay? You know, I went to a memorial this weekend. A good friend of mine passed away 6 months ago, and they did the memorial on him and everything. And I'm just, you start to think about things, about life and everything. What do I want to accomplish? What's my legacy? I want to enjoy life. Right? How many people want to enjoy life right now? Okay. Is there anything wrong with that? Not at all. Who's next here? Chris, was Chris and then Eric.
Yep. So I actually just secured a sale right before this call today, but it was from a lady I met with last week. And last week, you know, she was saying she didn't have the money, and the call kind of ended like, you know, she had to check her finances. And I was like, hey, you know, most people, they know how much money they got in the bank. They don't really need to do research. They have an idea off the top of their head. So it's okay to tell me no if you just want to tell me no, it's fine. And she's like, no, I'll let you know by the end of the day. So long story short, she let me know by the end of the day she couldn't do it. Surprise, right? So then I reached out to her over the weekend, and I was like, you know, say we could go ahead.
How did you reach out? I'm sorry to interrupt, but what did you just call her, text her, send a video?
No,
what?
I shot her a text message. So I shot her a text, right? So I said, hey, you know, let's say I could, you know, get creative, right? I never changed my price. Let's say I get creative and you could put something down, you could pay something per month, do a couple of deals, you pay me off. That's not something that could work for you, is it? And she was like, actually, yes, that could work for you. I'm like, great, let's hop on a call. So we hopped on a Zoom, and basically I was able to get her going. She put down $4,000, and then she's going to be paying $500 per month. And then last week I secured another sale for $9,800. So that was also exciting.
So how happy is Mrs. Logan?
Oh, she's very happy.
you know how you have the best marriage in the world, don't you?
Huh?
Make a shitload of money.
Exactly.
Does that sound horrible, but is it true? Yes or no? Give me a thumbs up.
Yeah, I mean, as long as everything's taken care of, you got everybody happy, you know?
Well, you remove, seriously, on a serious note. Okay. You remove one of the greatest stresses of a relationship. Yeah.
Yeah.
Financial.
Yep.
You know, what do people argue about in a lot of relationships?
Finances, money.
Finances, money. When you have more money than you need and you're both reasonable people and the bills are paid and the kids are taken care of and things like that, do you think you can work on yourselves? And do you think you remove that major pressure?
Absolutely.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm sorry if I'm politicizing here or whatever you call it. On it, but congratulations, Nitson. I didn't congratulate you. Nice going, man. Isn't it? And nice going, Chris. How much fun is it to make money by the sweat of your own brow, by doing things that your competition won't do, by talking to people, God forbid? How wonderful is that?
No, it's amazing. And you know, one of the things too that's so easy to forget is that we can be creative with our payment terms. It's so easy for you to throw out a price to someone and then say, no, I can't do it. I don't have the money. And then you jump to conclusions that they don't have any money whatsoever, right? But going to that price objection and then, you know, working out something creative where they put something down, pay something per month. While I was on the call with her this morning, it was so funny. I was like, so how much can you put down towards the coaching investment? And she was like, you know, 4 or 5. And I was like, 4 or 500. And I was, and she's like, no, 4 or 5,000. And I'm like, oh, okay. You had me sweating there for a minute. So, but it was cool.
That's great. Thank you for sharing that. Quick role play. Eric, yep. I didn't forget you. I will get to you. But my mentor used to always say, money is never an objection if the need is great enough. Give me the money objection. Let me show you a little guts technique here for somebody. You know this technique, you guys, my regulars, but let's show it for the new folks. Go ahead. Give me the money objection like she gave you.
Yeah. So, you know, I just really have to look at my finances here at the end of the day. I want to do the program, but it's just, you know, I got to make sure that I don't get myself into trouble. I'm sure you know what that's like.
Very reasonable. Very reasonable. Let's, you know what, for a moment, and I appreciate that. Thank you for your honesty and everything. I love this conversation. You know, we're both working towards the same end here. Let's imagine for a moment, my favorite word. Let's imagine for a moment money wasn't an issue. You still wouldn't want to work with me and do deals with me, or, I mean, if money wasn't an issue, and it's okay to say no, don't worry, you know, it's got to be right for you. If we took the money out of the picture completely, you still would not want to work with me, right?
Oh, no, I definitely would. I see a lot of value in your program, and I'd love to get started.
Boom. What just happened? Okay, thank you, Chris. That was great. Yeah. That was exactly what just happened. Who saw the move? Who started to become the salesperson? Go ahead, Randy. Unmute yourself.
She did, because you told her no. You would not want to work with me. Yeah, I would. Yeah, she became her own salesperson.
And I created an imagery in her mind. Sorry to call you Christine instead of Chris, Mr. Logan.
It's okay.
We took the imagery and we said, let's take the money out of it for a moment. Okay, I'm creating an image, a storyline in her mind. And if money wasn't an issue, and it's okay to say no. And then I elaborated and I gave them even permission to say no to me, totally removing the pressure, giving a scenario where money's not an issue, just to get to yes. What happens when we keep getting yeses? It's so important. It's so important. And Chris said, yes. Now I have to go back in the role play if we were to continue. Okay. And if you know in your business, real estate, whatever you do, coaching, whatever, can you now fix it with a note or some kind of financing or an alternative strategy? We're problem solvers. Okay. Well, how do you, in a competitive world, you've got to do things differently than your competition. You think your competition's doing moves like we talk about here every Monday? They're not doing this stuff, okay? All they're doing is throwing a lot of junk against the wall and hoping they get somebody who's so desperate or so motivated, you know, that needle in the haystack prospect. But we've got to work at it and be a little, what do you want them to, the thing I always say is, what do you want them to think when you get off the phone? You know, and just going back to the beginning, we talked about my favorite books. Sam Walton's whole was, if you had to describe Sam Walton, Okay. I love Walmarts, by the way. I just, to me, it's like Disneyland. I just love going in the, I love going in Walmart and looking at the people and looking at the displays. Do you, and in the book I read, Sam Walton would go to all his competitors and see what they were doing and doing better. Should we do that online? If we're, should we look for people in the same business as us and see what they're doing, how they're marketing, how they're selling, what kind of words they're using, what kind of podcasts or speaking? Should we check out our competition and maybe can we steal some ideas from other people? Yeah, that's what.
Oh, absolutely. I steal your ideas all the time.
God, that's what you're paying me for. Absolutely. You should, with my permission. Absolutely. But give me a citation once in a while. That's all I ask. The other thing is, if you had to, just a question. If you had to describe a Walmart, is it price or value?
Value.
Yeah. You know, so is money, when you, depending on what you charge for what you do, if you can solve somebody's problem, is price really an issue? If the value is great enough, they will overcome that value, won't they? Mm-hmm. I always use the joke, does anyone want the cheapest heart surgery? No, absolutely not. Eric, I apologize, buddy. These people are triggering me today. I'm sorry. Go for it, buddy.
I'm taking notes. That's good. But yeah, my big win, got the largest land development contract I've had to date by doing, unlike anything that my competition will do, I actually met with the seller in person. They wrote me a note afterwards after signing the contract. We have a lot of confidence in your abilities and trust you will do well. It's a pleasure meeting you and making this work with you. So they're thanking me to sell me this deal. And it's going to be, it's
why
like,
are they awesome. Thanking you? Let's go a little deep here. Why do you think they're thanking you?
I helped them understand what they're, what, yeah.
You're making money and they're thanking you?
I showed them how much money I was going to make. Yeah.
That's very interesting what you just said. I show people the contract. When I get a contract and I want to sell or wholesale that contract or something like that, I actually show it to people. What do you think goes through someone's mind? You're doing a real estate deal. Let's say you got a house, just for an example, or maybe your example. You got a house for $200,000. It's got a value of $200,000, and you got it for $125,000, and you want to sell it for $25,000. Do you think? What do you think? Do you think you're entitled to that $25,000 if you know they can make $50,000?
Absolutely.
Yeah, and it's fair. Can you use scarcity and social proof to walk away from the deal if they give you? Well, you just got that. Hey, Eric, you just got that deal and you just got that deal yesterday, Sunday, and you're making $25,000. You know, something's wrong with that.
That's terrible. I'm making so much money on this thing. It's crazy. It's going to be sick. But, you know, I think that you probably make a whole lot more if you want to do this deal today.
Well, I'll give you, $25 is too much. You're not entitled to make that much money.
You're going to make all the money, huh? You're going to take it all off the bone for me?
Yeah, yeah. Wait, now, this is where you, instead of being off the role play, this is what I would do. I wouldn't argue with them. I would just say, you know, it's okay to say no to me. I've got 20 other people to call. Someone's going to make $50,000 today. Unfortunately, it doesn't sound like it's going to be you. Is there anything else before I leave?
What way to pop the balloon of pressure there. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Take it away. Scarcity, social proof, authority. These are key. Now you still want to stroke and nurture. Hey, I appreciate your opinion. Thank you for sharing it. I'm only taking a small portion. I think a 25% of the prof, you're going to get 50,000 if you wanted to do a deal, but that's not enough. And I respect that. I guess somebody else is going to make $50,000 on the equity of this deal today, but it's not going to be you. Is there anything else, Mr. Eric, before we leave?
I guess that's, maybe I'm being a little harsh. I mean, maybe we should renegotiate this thing here.
you know, I'd love to do business with you today. You and I have never done a deal before. I'm very good at finding deals, and I'd love to, this would be our first deal, and there'll be many more after this. And I always like to see my partners make money. God, that sounds like a scene from The Godfather. Where is that? Is it Godfather where he goes to the old man in Florida and the old man says, I always made money from my partners. Help me out, somebody. Who's a Godfather fan here? I love that movie. Eric, how much are you going to make, buddy?
I need to get it entitled, but if I'm able to turn this land into a 10 unit property, I'll make several hundred thousand dollars on it. I'm buy price of 195. I should be